their band ruled.
Guys, why don't you introduce yourselves to our listeners?
My name's Travis, I play guitar.
I'm Barry, I play the drums.
My name's Anna, and
until
for the last week, my wife's been asking me why I travel halfway across the country to see this guy that I hated. For whatever reason, our band really meant something to people. But in the end, it didn't work out. It'd been 6 years since any of us had seen one another. But I promised Travis we'd spend our 30th birthdays together. Me and Travis and Anna.
Ready?
Oh my God.
At least one of us made it right.
She was a star in Europe and in Asia. But to me, she was just the one who got away.
In the heart of the desert.
Are you guys rekindling your thing?
You know, we need a guitarist. Every girl wanted to be with you, and every guy wanted to be you.
All of us, we're here right now. The band's together. This is the band.
No, there's no band.
None of us were ever going to be John effing Lennon.
You need to do something real.
I'm a productive member of society. I'm not some loner losing his mind out in the desert.
Come with me.
A new journey begins.
This place has so much spirit.
An event that would change their lives.
It's not just a cave. You go into the cave, your deepest desire comes true.
Do you know what your problem is, Anna? You don't want what's good for you.
It's a cave. How do you think it works?
I just want you to grab me like this, right? Stop laughing at me.
They would get a second chance to find their dreams.
You left.
You compromise one thing, you compromise everything.
While there's something to be said about dreams and what we're told as children that we can do and achieve anything, it's also kind of a huge goddamn lie.
Stop!
Is this your new method of seduction?
She nursed you in the hospital for 3 months after your doped-up ass wrapped a car around the tree.
I need to tell you something. I saw that tree.
One woman torn between two lovers.
This is what I dreamed. This is what I wanted.
That is honest animal rage.
Travis!
You want to know why I never went in that cave? Afraid to find out what I needed.
I thought you made it up.
Yeah.
3 nights in the desert.
WMPW Bard College Radio. Guys, why don't you introduce yourselves to our listeners?
My name's Travis. I play guitar.
I'm Barry. I play the drums.
My name's Anna, and I sing.
So tell me, how did the band meet?
I closed my eyes, and I imagined this ray of light.
Shut up.
Well, believe it or not, we were all born the same week, so Travis and I were really drunk celebrating our birthday. And we ran into Anna really drunk celebrating her birthday.
So wasted.
Improvising song after song.
Yes.
So where do you see yourselves down the road? Where do you see yourselves 10 years from now?
I really think we keep doing what we're doing. Working hard, making the right choices, and we'll be doing huge things in 10 years.
I feel like we're on a path. If it has some twists and turns or whatever, we're going to make it happen.
Wait, I got your crystal ball right here. This is the road we're on. In 10 years, we'll either be famous or dead.
It's been 6 years since any of us had seen one another. Me and Travis and Anna. We all went our separate ways. But I promised Travis we'd spend our 30th birthdays together. For the last week, my wife's been asking me why I travel halfway across the country to see this guy that I hated. The truth is, I've never loved anyone more. For whatever reason, our band really meant something to people. I mean, we had fans. But in the end, it didn't work out. And I've always felt a little bit guilty about that. If I had known Anna was going to be here this weekend, I never would have come.
Are you guys rekindling your thing?
Never had a thing.
So let me guess. She knows I'm coming.
Yeah. Who cares?
Brilliant.
Let it go. Be here. You look good here. Trust me.
She'd gone on to make something of herself. She was a star in Europe and in Asia. But to me, she was just the one who got away. Anyway. So why did I come back? Maybe I just needed to prove to myself I could. Maybe it's because I made a promise. Or maybe I was hoping to get a glimpse of the magic again.
You look good. You look damn good. You lost some weight.
Yeah. Yeah, Julie and I made this plan. We do a 5-mile jog before breakfast. Every day.
Well, I'm glad you came out. I know it's hard to get away.
Ready?
Oh my God.
Well, this is so cool.
Oh.
At least one of us made it, right?
Well, I haven't exactly made it,
but... I think there's 500,000 YouTube viewers that would disagree.
People would come up to her in the street singing her songs.
Well, how do you leave all your adoring fans?
It was time.
See that? That's where I'm taking you tonight.
What's over there?
You'll see.
Still limping. You did all you could. You guys.
Yes, indeed.
Well said, brother.
Here, here.
Man, I haven't had food in forever.
What do you mean, food?
I mean, and last year I decided no more sauces.
Come on, you're from Kansas. You can't betray your roots. A man needs steak sauce.
I figure why dump liquid all over your food.
Taste?
Yeah.
Taste.
I'm gonna go with that.
Does it taste? Would be another reason.
Oh, in Cambodia, I've got this fish sauce that they put on everything. It's amazing. Very hot, and it makes your tongue feel like it's disintegrating.
Wow.
Yeah.
God, you've been everywhere.
Yeah.
The only traveling I do is for work or wedding. At least I'm building a frequent flyer miles.
Me too.
Yeah?
Yeah.
What's yours?
A little thing called Premier.
Premier exec.
I should have known that. All right.
You gotta earn the unlimited domestic upgrade.
How did you do that?
I'm sorry, this is great. The best is the story when I got it. I was this close and I realized that it would work. And all of a sudden I just got up from my desk and flew to Seattle for lunch and back just to earn my status.
Sitting here with.
Guy with his piercing blue eyes. He's got frosted tips.
Okay.
He's got a lot of gel in it. It's looking like a real, you know, a douchebag.
Oh.
And I said to myself, Anna, you must know this man.
With a scholarship kid, I was dropping $50 on a hairstylist. That's a tool.
Shut up. Every girl wanted to be with you and every guy wanted to be you. And we got high just being around you.
Yeah, it's because I gave you drugs.
That's true. Good point. Speaking of which, hello?
No.
We met that day, too.
You weren't there.
I guess my first impressions don't set rivers on fire. But I'm a slow boil. Come on, I was sexy, right? Say yes.
Tonight is all about you, dude. Happy birthday. It's your night.
Okay.
Tomorrow, Anna.
What about you?
No! Good. You guys coming out here is plenty for me.
Oh, that is some regal shit. Cheers.
That's you.
I'm here.
All right, check this out. Yeah.
What is it?
Yeah.
No way.
Oh, no.
Looks like you're about to tell him the secret to the universe.
I'm still waiting for that one.
Yeah, that's later. This is my first bear man encounter. So I'm 5, maybe 6, and I go into the school bathroom, and I see a perfect pile of clothing. There's Velcro shoes at the bottom with these socks tucked neatly inside. There were sweatpants folded on top, military style, and on top of it all, a t-shirt. And then I realize this kid takes shits completely naked. So I figure I gotta get to know this kid. This is an interesting kid. A couple days later, I see him out in the playground. He's being chased by this asshole kid. What do you call himself? Skeletor?
Skeletor.
Chasing him around, harassing him with this plastic crossbow. And I wait for the right time, and they come around, and I go, whack!
Oh.
Knock him on his ass. Stand over him, point to Barry, and I say, that's my best friend. Okay. I didn't even know your name. Oh, wait a second. Wait just 1 second. This is great. We go on the school trip to D.C., right? And everybody knows Bear Man. He's like the horniest guy in school, right? So he whacks it 4 times, 5 times a day or something like that. And we're all staying together. And so, you know, he's got to hold off. And he's just getting angrier and angrier the whole trip. And I looked at him. I was like, Barry, why are you so upset? He's like, oh, man, I'm just so horny. When I get home, I could whack it to anything. And I'm like, anything? You could whack it to anything, Bear Man? Like anything, anything at all. Yeah, I could whack it to anything. I could whack it to, I don't even know where he got this. I could whack it to a golden fucking cube.
A golden cube.
What?
Can I please take over the story here? A golden cube because it's floating in space and it's in a vacuum. It's devoid of any sexuality. It's a competitive challenge.
Yeah.
He didn't make that clear.
Wow.
So I get home, I lay on my bed, and I focus. And I'm picturing this gold cube floating in space. And then I think of Stacy Carter. Or some other hot chick. And I stop, I wait, I become fully flaccid, start from scratch, and I do it again. And I did it.
You did.
I did it.
We don't know if you did it. Nobody knows if you did it. How do you prove that? How do you prove that?
I guess you just have to trust my word.
Hey, here's to being pathologically honest.
Pathologically honest, Barry.
You be quiet. Shut up. Get in my mouth.
Happy birthday to us, right?
To you.
Me.
It's your night.
Happy birthday. That's my terrible birthday song.
Yeah, you killed it, yeah.
I need more booze.
This is giving me anxiety.
Shh, make a wish. Nice.
It's almost time.
For what?
This cave, it's not just a cave. Shh. People have been coming here for centuries. I saw a pack of coyotes standing where you are, just staring in. You going to the cave? Your deepest desire comes true.
Does that mean there's like a genie that's in a bottle in there?
No, no. None of that genie shit. See, the genies, they give you what you want. This cave knows what you need.
I think I'd rather have the genie in the bottle.
I think you're just like anything. That's in a bottle.
Shut up.
You.
Go on. Oh, come on, Travis, please. Come on, you see it.
Go on. You scared?
Yes. Okay, going in.
No.
Okay, all right.
So narrow.
Have you been in there? What's that dripping sound?
Okay.
Are you okay?
Yeah. Yeah. Bet that's good for the property value, huh? Magical cave. You should go in, Barry. It's fun.
pretty cool.
Yeah, cool.
Should we,
You're not going in?
No, no.
Travis.
To this magical cave.
No, we didn't do drugs. I promise.
Who's my monster?
Good night.
Got everything you need?
yeah.
I love you, Bear Man. I love you, Bear Man.
Good night, dude.
I said I love you. I love you, Bear Man. I love you, Bear Man.
Love you too, man.
All right. All right.
Okay?
Yeah, sorry, it's just a bad dream.
It's just got startled.
What's going on?
Just a bad dream. Just screaming.
What kind of dream?
It's nothing. Really?
Yeah.
Yeah. Good night.
Hey, I'm just checking out the latest from the New World. Travis.
Oh.
You even sleep with this thing?
It's not fine.
You must be hooked.
Don't stay up too late.
Look, I'm figuring it out. Yes. Soon, okay? Okay. I love you too.
Nice to me now. I'm a cripple.
Got it? Yeah! Still got it. See that?
Yeah.
You check out his patented, I mean business move. He pushes his glasses back on the bridge of his nose when he's about to kick it into another gear. Ready, Bearman? Ready?
Yeah.
Yeah!
Another friend decided to come.
Woo!
She's got the bedroom. Anna, it's a surprise for me too. Okay. Yes, I took my jog. It was gorgeous.
Pictured you out here.
Oh, yeah? That's what you'd imagine?
You know, we need a guitarist.
You're playing with some good musicians.
Yes. They're good. We need a wild man. Be like old times. Except now you're a silver fox.
You believe Bearman's jogging?
Mm-hmm.
numbers all colored in your head. You can't resist because my love's got a half-life. One by one, it's seven times. And the dealer whispers into your ear, you better bet it all. Because my love's got a half-life, and you have carried the ones who remain too long. And the sphere whispers into your ear, you better bet it all. You better bet it all.
Thank you. Oh,
try it great. On. I think I got the right size.
Dude, you look great.
It's jogging, dude.
Yeah, you look good.
Feels good.
Fits, I love it. Open yours.
Yeah.
Couldn't stand the idea of you having all these songs stuck in your head, so wanted you to be able to record them.
Thanks.
Mm-hmm. When I was out there on the road, everything felt like a dream. It just felt so unreal. And then when I got back, it was like everything is too real. I feel like I have to choose a path. And even if I don't choose a path, you know, that's like choosing a path, so no matter what.
Exactly. It's kind of startling how similar it is to what I've been thinking about the last few years.
Yeah.
You were saying?
Oh, I'm just saying that I feel the pressure of choosing a path, you know, but I want it to be the right one. I know we're all, you know, we're super busy and we really screwed each other over a lot. But fuck. I miss you guys.
Yeah. I want to know what Barry's thinking. What are you thinking, Barry?
I don't know. We gotta stay friends. For sure.
No, I mean in general. What are you hoping for?
I don't know. I feel lucky.
Really, that's all? It's not... nothing else? I mean...
Well, I mean, I guess there's things that I will want, but right now, basically, I've got it. And honestly, what's cool is this stability. The best part about it is this sense of independence.
being a tax attorney gives you a sense of independence?
Okay, sure. I have partners looking over my shoulder and I'm super busy. But I get my work done, I put in my hours, and everything's under control. It's, to me, that's independence. Look, there are a lot of paths out there, and that can be paralyzing, and I'm just happy I found the right one.
Impressive, you know that? I mean, from a Darwinian perspective, it's impressive, man. I get needing to make a living, I get it. It's just the way you embrace the whole thing as the one and only path.
I didn't say that.
Yeah, you kind of said that.
No, it's impressive. It really is.
Okay.
Here's how I see it. You got a bag of marbles in front of you. And you reach into the bag, and you're thinking, man, I'd like a blue marble. Blue marble would be great. I really want blue. You reach in that bag, you pull it out, bam, red. And you're like, well, that's red. That's not blue, I really want it blue. But you know what, red's okay. Yeah, no, red's good. Red's just fine. I reach into that bag, and I'm looking for the shiny marble, man. I'm looking for the shiniest marble in there, and I reach for it. If I miss it, I reach for it again, and I reach for it again, because I'm gonna get that fucker.
Okay, maybe you just pass up a bunch of perfectly good marbles because it's not exactly what you pictured.
Okay, now we're talking, all right.
Whatever, I didn't mean that.
No, I think it's the first thing you meant all weekend. Hey, maybe you're right. Maybe if we went with the jackass manager, it would have been our ticket.
That jackass manager? He's worked with some serious bands. Okay, have you seen what he's done for Marvin Taylor's band? Or the Resistance?
Resistance? You mean the Connecticut suburbanites who think they're Che Guevara?
Well, they're still together.
They do suck.
They do suck. They suck. They sit there singing about La Revolución with a wink and a smile and their cocks in their hands.
Well, they put out another album, so.
Good for those clowns. I'm happy for them. Makes me feel like anything's possible.
I'm just saying they make a living.
I'm just saying I don't want to hear about it.
Excuse me. Do you know how hard Anna worked to get us hooked up? Do you have any idea?
Yeah, she pounded the pavement. I get it.
No, you don't get it, okay? She worked her ass off because we had a chance.
A chance? A chance?
Yes.
For what? That guy would have watered down our sound before we even knew what our sound was.
You don't have a sound if you can't pay your rent.
You compromise one thing, you compromise everything, man. The great bands, the really great bands, they struggle. But I don't think you have that in your DNA.
What is with your mixed metaphors and your evolutionary bullshit? And what's so bad about being a decent working band?
I didn't go through all that shit to make something decent.
Look, none of us were ever going to be John effing Lennon, okay? And maybe you're still holding on to that. And while there's something to be said about dreams and what we're told as children that we can do and achieve anything, it's also kind of a huge goddamn lie.
So what? You've moved on?
Yeah. I mean, we gave it a few years. Okay? I had to find a real profession.
Music's a real profession.
Yes.
Look, man, if you would have just told us that you were applying to law school,
you would have talked me out of it.
Oh, I'm that convincing? Maybe I should have been the fucking lawyer.
It was shitty when you left. It was.
Excuse me, no, excuse me for once that I made a decision that was for the benefit of myself.
Mary.
Soaking up the good times. Thanks for having us, Travis.
You need to do something good, man. Something real.
Me? Me do something real? That's actually very funny, coming from you. I'm a productive member of society. What do you do? I'm not some loner losing his mind out in the fucking desert.
to tell you something.
Come with me. My uncle liked to look up at the sky. Near the end, he couldn't take my son. He wasn't an easy man. But we understood each other. When I left New York, I knew I was coming here. And when I arrived, he'd been expecting me. He loved listening to me play, and I loved watching him listen. One afternoon, I was playing and looked over at him. And he was just staring. Up. Quiet. Never seen quiet like that before. I went outside and I burned all my songbooks. And my lyrics, all that, finally it had a purpose. So maybe you're right. What I've done, I can't pay my mortgage with it. Won't get me on any magazine covers. Helping a man die. What is that worth? It's like 1,000. 100,000. It's like a jam outside. You can't put a dollar sign on it. This place has so much spirit. It has its blessing. We start our album here. Our songs are gonna break people wide open, man.
Listen.
I know it's what you want. You brought the recorder.
Yeah, I mean, look, I've definitely written some new songs while I've been here.
yeah, that'd be cool.
I'd be down to try it out.
I was thinking we'd do something together.
Or we could start with what we have.
Nah, I was thinking we should start with something new, right? New, right? What?
It's always on your terms.
What?
Forget it.
What? Whoa, what? All of us together.
This is too much for me.
Too much? Too much is a good thing. I live for too much. All of us, we're here right now. The band's together. This is the band.
No, there's no band. There's no band, man. It's not gonna be a band again. I have a home, I have a career, a wife. This is a fantasy.
This is a fantasy.
Travis. Travis. Fuck. You know what? This is my fault. My fault. I said some dumb shit to him. I sang. I got him the recorder, and this morning I asked him to play guitar in my band.
Bet that would work out real well.
It would be good for him.
For him, exactly.
You know what, Barry? You left. I was in the hospital when he was recovering. You stopped returning his phone calls.
You left too. You left the country.
He wouldn't talk to me. He needed you.
And I needed to start my life. You know something? You never even given me a fraction of this concern.
Don't.
What?
Don't.
Don't what?
Barry, you're happy. You're well-adjusted, man.
And what's wrong with that? Do you know what your problem is, Anna? You don't want what's good for you. And if you were single for longer than a nanosecond, you'd have a little bit of perspective.
You don't really think that, do you?
What about hedge fund guy?
Oh, Barry, that's... Guy was a rebound.
How am I supposed to feel about some rich dude tossing you around before you have Olympic sex?
Who said that?
You did.
Fuck.
For your information, I've become a pretty good lover.
Nobody's doing.
Sing Driftwood for me. Please. Sing my song for me. Songs about Travis. Doesn't work for you. Only an asshole can hold your attention longer than 2 weeks.
Both said it was a mistake.
And then you thought, you know what? Maybe I'll start screwing Travis again. You and him in a bathroom stall? While I was waiting for you. That's Stella's.
Barry, come on.
Even then, I thought, you know what? Maybe she's just working something out. Maybe she just needs the time.
Hey. Hey, you're like my brother.
I know. You just want me to grab you like this, right? Is this what you wanted? Should have grabbed you like this. Stop fucking laughing at me. Stop! This is what you respond to, right? This is what you want. I know what I'm gonna do. I know what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna fuck you like a psychopath. I'm gonna fuck you so that you forget his name. I'm gonna fuck you so that you write every song about me. I'm gonna fuck you so you remember.
Barry, don't. Barry. Barry! You're fucking drunk!
You going to the cave? Your deepest desire comes true.
No. Are you okay? Hello?
Yeah.
Listen, you're drunk and confused. I get that, okay? Okay? Nightmare. Wait.
Something awful in it? Or is it about him?
It's about me.
you eggs in the morning. Just the way you like them. Then we'll go home.
Yeah.
Get some sleep.
Radio guys, why don't you introduce yourself to our listeners?
My name's Travis.
I'm Barry. I play the drums. And I like ice cream.
My name's Anna, and I sing.
So tell me, how did the band meet?
I closed my eyes, and I imagined this ray of light.
Well, believe it or not, we were all born in the same week, so Travis and I were really drunk celebrating our birthday. And we ran into Anna really drunk celebrating her birthday.
So wasted.
I think at one point you
smashed. And just improvising song after song.
Yes.
I could barely stand up.
You killed it.
Amazing.
So where do you see yourselves down the road? Where do you see yourselves 10 years from now?
I really think we keep doing what we're doing, working hard, making the right choices, and we'll be doing huge things in 10 years.
I feel like we're on a path. If it has some twists and turns or whatever, we're going to make it happen.
Wait, I got your crystal ball right here. This is the road we're on. 10 years, we'll either be famous or dead.
Keys anywhere? I can't see if I can find them.
Can't find my cell phone.
Yeah. some night, huh?
Somewhere.
Yo! Yo, yo, yo!
Did you enjoy your night in the desert?
Yeah!
It was real nice. How about your night,
Barry?
Yeah. It's fine.
You got nicked up good there, partner.
An encounter with the counter.
What else you guys do last night?
We hung out, okay?
Something wrong, brother?
I guess the night didn't go as planned.
Oh. Things not going according to plan for Barry. Wow. Tell me more.
I thought we came here to hang out.
I thought we were being truthful.
Is this what you wanted? Should have grabbed you like this. Stop fucking laughing at me. Stop!
Oh my God.
I know what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna fuck you like a psychopath.
Travis. Travis, give me that. Give it to me.
Yeah, I had to cool down. Thought I'd see if you two were getting along.
Oh, you asshole.
You should have told me if you wanted to write the first song together.
Just stop, please.
Wow.
Stop.
Which one of you is doing that?
Would you please stop?
That psychopath line? That's a good one. I'm gonna have to use that.
You're fucking drunk!
You're staying here tonight. We're making that album.
Jesus Christ.
Where are you going?
Travis? Travis. Listen, man. Look, we're all exhausted. Let's not be idiots. Just give me the rest of my shit back.
Stay.
I've got a flight.
Change it.
I can't just change my flight.
Use your miles.
Oh, come on, man. I've got work tomorrow.
Call in sick.
Julie's expecting me. She's expecting me to call now. We talk every morning.
Well, you're gonna have to give her the latest update. Or I can.
Stop!
Is this your new method of seduction? Come on, take a shot. But be careful. You know who wins a fight, don't you? Not the strongest or the tallest. The craziest. I got you beat there, although I think you're catching up pretty quick. Should I punch him in the other eye, or do you think it's just gonna turn him on? Oh. Yeah. Yeah. Woo! Barry, that's pure, man. That is honest animal rage. You feel that? Right? Three of us, when we're apart, we're just children. We're making a mess of things, but together we're like a 90-year-old desert guru. No, fuck that. It multiplies. We're 30 times 30 times 30. What is that? What is that, Barry?
Who cares, man?
Count it up. 30 times 30, that's 2,700.
It's 27,000.
2,700-year-old man. We're older than Christ. We're older than Socrates. We're older than fucking Buddha. So let's do it. Let's take that right here. Let's make the album. Three nights in the desert.
I don't even play anymore, man.
That's great. That's great. The nameless is the eternally real. You're making artistic choices and you don't even know it, man.
Look, Travis, listen, give us our stuff back. I'll go home. We'll chalk this whole thing up to desert fever. Come on. When I get back, I'll call you. And we'll talk about the idea for the tour. I know it's nuts, but the offer still stands.
I don't need a sympathy job.
It's not a sympathy job. It's a real gig for money.
And I can't.
Why not?
I don't want to get into it.
Come on, Travis.
Say it.
I don't like your music. I don't. You took the stuff we were working on and you popped it up. You put a syncopated dance beat to it. You sugarcoated it. Digestible. Not you. Hey, but it was your big break. I get it.
You know what? You think you're a genius? You're just down.
I might not be reinventing the form, but at least I've done something.
You asked me.
This is what you do to your friends? What does it take to get your approval, man? She nursed you in the hospital for 3 months after your doped-up ass wrapped a car around the tree.
Okay.
Her whole album is about you.
I know that.
I'm done. I want to go home.
Why are you screaming in the night?
Come on, Travis. Please. I just want to go home.
I know how powerful it is. I gave my uncle everything, and he showed me that place in return.
Please, I just want to get out of here.
There's plenty of time before your flight, so go back in the cave, figure things out. You know what you need to do.
One thing you should know before you go in. I used your phone to email Julie the recording. Julie, right?
Yeah. No, you didn't.
I'm not joking.
Yes, you are.
No, I'm not.
Yes, you are.
I am?
Yes.
I think I am. I don't know. Confusion. Uncertainty. That's what you need when you go in there. You got what you wanted the first time.
What did you see when you went in there?
Happy?
Are you?
I'm swell, partner.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Well, then I want you, the pathologically honest, to look us in the eye and tell us that you're completely happy with your life.
Okay. I'm happy.
Look at us.
All right, guys. Listen, I'm happy. Are you happy?
No.
Huh? Are you happy? I'm happy. Happy, happy, happy. We're all happy.
I'm not happy, but I want you to say that I'm completely happy with my life.
I'm completely happy with my life. I'm completely happy with my life. All right, Rockwall. Hi, Rockwall. I'm completely happy with my life. How are you today? Are you happy with your life?
That's not gonna cut it, man.
I'm completely happy with my life. Better now?
No.
No. All right. This is fucking ridiculous. You think I don't love Julie?
And you tell me you never had a doubt?
What do you know about choices? What do you know about marriage or commitment to anything that's actually attainable?
What about you, man? I mean, you could train yourself to want anything. A golden fucking cube?
That was a joke.
You know what wasn't a joke? What happened last night.
Okay, I screwed up. I'm disgusting, and that's something I gotta work out
Barry,
within myself.
I'm not judging you, man.
Do you know why I didn't invite you to my wedding? It wasn't because I was afraid you'd make a scene or steal Julie, no. I was afraid you'd say she's boring because you're so judgmental. Or you'd say she's nice. Or you wouldn't say anything at all because you're so fucking judgmental.
Barry.
I saw the world through your eyes for way too long. And I made a choice. I wanted something different from my life.
And I get it, you know? It's biological, I think. You know, you're... at a certain point, you're supposed to stop hanging out with friends. Yeah, you're supposed to become a functioning member of society. You're supposed to churn out babies and punch fucking numbers and ride the train and cash in. Yeah, baby, I get it.
You have no place to go, do you? I'm completely happy with you not in my life.
Yeah.
You're an asshole.
Yeah, I'm a fucking asshole.
Anna?
The world needs fucking assholes.
Anna.
Anna, wait. Anna.
Anna.
Travis!
I'm good, I'm fine, fine, fine. I'm good.
This is what I dreamed. The cave wanted you to hurt. They wanted you to hurt like I've hurt. This is what I wanted. This.
No, no, I don't.
It is.
No.
It is.
I made it up, okay? I made up the whole cave thing. I thought it'd be cool and mysterious. I thought it'd make us miss each other. Yeah.
I don't care about the cave. I don't care. This is what's real.
I know.
When you were in the hospital recovering, those were the best moments of our relationship. You looked at me like you needed me.
I need to tell you something. Both of you. I tried writing, calling. You were gonna move halfway across the country. And I was losing it. Yeah, I was hopped up on pills and... Yeah, it was dark. But I saw that tree. I saw it. It was telling me to hit it. Hit it, and I'd be redeemed. We'd all be redeemed. It was music. I was listening. I went for it. Went for the shiny fucking marble. I went into it.
One night to be confused, one night to speed up truth. We had a promise paid for hands and then away, both under a simple touch, one night to push and scream, and then relief. 10 days of perfect tunes, the colors red and blue. We had a promise made. We were in
back in the day. I thought I was a jaguar doing 100 down the freeway, and you. Or a beat up old Toyota. Not exactly sure where you were heading, but I had the feeling that when you got there, you'd stay. And now, shit. You got somewhere. Man, you could trade it for a whole fleet.
You should see my bills.
did good. You went back to school and put in the time. Now you're set to reap the rewards. Maybe in my next life I'll come back as a hard-working Jew.
Some people that might find that offensive.
Yeah. I'm just glad you found what's right for you. You remember the way back, right? It's just one road. You want to know why I never went in that cave? I was afraid to find out what I needed.
I thought you made it up.
Yeah.
Travis said he'd hitch a ride and pick up the truck in a few days. I knew that look. He was deep back in it. I kept thinking about the cave. Maybe we did get what we needed that weekend. We finally let go. Travis used to say it's all a song. We never did find that bridge. Maybe one day we will.
Life, you carry the ones that remain for far.
whisper into your ear, you better bet it all.